Panchakaupatarubhyascha kripa sindubhayeva cha patitanam pavanebhyo vaishnavibhyo namo namaha. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadha Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're hearing about Narada Muni, who's traveling to different places throughout the universe, looking for the devotee who's received the greatest mercy from Lord Krishna.
我们正在聆听的是，Narada Muni他是如何在整个宇宙不同的地方旅行，去寻找哪位奉献者得到了主 Krishna 最大的仁慈。
So he had come to Prahlad Maharaj, and he thought Prahlad Maharaj has received the greatest mercy from Krishna.
他来到 Prahlad Maharaj 面前，他认为是 Prahlad Maharaj 得到了主 Krishna 最大的仁慈。
But Prahlad Maharaj does not agree. He says, "No, no, no." He said, "I'm not the great devotee."
但是 Prahlad Maharaj 矢口否认说，不，我并没有得到主 Krishna 最大的仁慈。
And Prahlad Maharaj says that Prahlad said, "I have never done any real service for the Lord."
Prahlad Maharaj 说，我从来没有为主 Krishna 做过什么真正的服务。
Real service of the Lord are people like Hanuman. I only remember the Lord sometimes when my mind was troubled, but Hanuman, he does service for the Lord.
Hanuman 才真正的为主 Krishna 做了服务。我只是有的时候在心烦意乱的时候意念起主 Krishna， 而 Hanuman 他为主做了真正的服务。
So Narada Muni would say, "But you are a devotee of Lord Vishnu, and so you deserve his mercy."
Narada Muni 说，但是你是主威士努真正的奉献者，你配得到他的仁慈啊。
But Prahlad says, "Well, look at people like Hanuman, and they have how much service they're active devotees. They're serving the Lord."
普拉德说：“但是你看一下哈努曼，他真正的在做着活跃的服务。”Prahlad
said, "I'm only practicing meditation."
普拉德说：“我只是在那里练习着冥想罢了。”I haven't
become very expert even in that. I'm still trying to perfect my meditation.
而且我甚至在冥想方面呢，也并不很擅长。我只是在使我的冥想变得完美。But
Narada, he would say, "Well, to fix your mind on the Lord, that's one of the 9 kinds of devotional service."
Narada 说，但是将心意专注于主，也是九项纯粹奉献服务之一。
And remembering the Lord's names and forms and pastimes, that's on the highest level of bhakti yoga.
意念主的名字、形体、逍遥时光，处在奉爱瑜伽的最高的自我觉悟层面。So
when we talk about devotional service, we should understand that this does not deny, and you know, if somebody's actually doing devotional service, we shouldn't say that person has never actually served the Lord, because they can be serving the Lord by remembering him in their mind.
当一个人在心意当中 当中，通过意念主，以这种方式在服务着主的时候，我们不能否认说他并没有在服务主。
But Prahlad, he says, well, look at me. He said, I'm disturbed and I have so much anxiety, and so that disqualifies me. I only remember the Lord because I'm so disturbed. I have so much anxiety. So it's not that I'm actually doing real meditation and remembrance of the holy name or the form of the Lord.
Prahlad 说，看一下我这种情况，我只是在心烦意乱的时候，心意受到打扰的时候，才想着主。这并不是真正的在做着这个奉献服务。
Yeah, just to remember the Lord, that's not the highest kind of devotional service.
仅仅意念主并不是最高级的奉献服务。
Because remembering the Lord depends on the functions of the mind, and the mind is always subject to so many distractions and different emotions.
因为意念主是依赖于心意的功能，而心意呢，它是总是有时候三心二意，或者是它从在情绪当中。
So this is one of the problems with just trying to remember the Lord and not actually do service.
这就是意念主的问题所在，并不是真正的在服务。
So Prahlad says to Narada Muni, he said, you're praising me because the Lord caressed me and showed me some signs of affection.
Prahlad 又继续说道，你在赞美我，只是因为主曾经爱抚过我，并且向我展示了其他的慈爱。
Yeah, he caressed him. It was like an embrace, you know.
主他以前他就是拥抱了我。
So some people consider that kind of affectionate behavior, that was just they think that's just a show of Maya. And other people think it's just a display of his pastimes.
但是有些人认为。被得到拥抱仅仅是一种玛雅假象的表示，并且其他人呢认为它只是一种逍遥时光。
So for people like the Advaitavadis, the monists who follow Sankaracharya, they think that the dealings between the devotees and the Supreme Lord, they think this is all just illusion.
对于那些Advaitavadi或者是假象宗学派的人士，他们认为与主和奉献者之间的爱心交流是虚幻的。
They think that the Supreme Absolute Truth, the Supreme Lord, could not become involved in these kind of dealings, that because there's some kind of duality there, so they think the Lord would never do these kind of things.
他们认为主，至尊觉得真理，他不可能是卷入到这种二元性的活动当中。
But the devotees, they say, no, this is actually the pastimes of the Lord.
但是奉献者们说，并不是这样子的，这是主的逍遥时光。
It's not just illusion, but this is the highest spiritual reality.
这不是幻象，这是最高的灵性的真相。
And we should understand that the personality of Godhead has all kinds of transcendental qualities.
人格守神，他拥有各式各样超然的品质。
He has a body which is eternal, full of bliss and knowledge, and with the help of his transcendental body.He can engage in all kinds of transcendental pastimes.
他 他的形体是永恒知识和极乐的，在他的躯体的在永恒知识极乐的能量的帮助下，他可以从事于永恒知识和极乐的活动。
So Prahlad's saying that when the Lord displays affection for his devotees, that they're real. These shows of affection are real.
Prahlad 认为，当主展示他的慈爱的时候呢，这是真的。
And the Lord does these things just for his own pleasure, for his own enjoyment.
主展示出这样的行为举止，只是为了他自己的快乐。
But Prahlad still thinks Lord Nrsingadev did this, embraced him, and showed affection to him just to pretend to care about him.
Prahlad 认为呢，主这样的表现呢，只是在假装，在关照他。
Yeah, just like sometimes your parents will do these things with their children. Sometimes they don't actually feel it, but they just do it. It's just for their pleasure.
就像父母亲有的时候，他们对孩子展示出这拥抱呢，只是表面上在这样去做，他们并没有真正的这种感受。
So.Prahlad said, these affectionate displays are actually natural symptoms of the love of the Lord.
这些爱的展示
Prahlad says to Narada that you think these are actual symptoms of love for the Lord.
Prahlad 对 Narada 说，您认为这些展示是真实的爱的征兆。
But Prahlad said, I think that it's not really real, it's just a dream.
但是我认为它不是真实的，它是梦。
And even if we accept them as real, it doesn't really mean the mercy of the Lord.
即便就是真的而已，它也并不是表明主就是展示了他的仁慈。
So Narada Muni is an expert authority on the glories of the Supreme Lord.
Narada Muni 就在主的赞美主的荣耀方面是一个专家。
And Lord Nrsingadev showed affection towards Prahlad Maharaj, and that affection came from the Lord's compassion.
主 Nrsingadev 向 Prahlad 展示了他的慈爱，这是源于他的怜悯之心。
So someone may say, well, that does not mean that the Lord had any special feeling for Prahlad.
有的人可能会这么说，这并不意味着主对 Prahlad 真的有这种特殊的情感。
Because the Lord shows his mercy to everyone, not just only to a few people. The Lord is merciful to everyone.
因为主的仁慈是遍洒的，到每个生物，并不是对某人特殊的。
Just like a fire, the heat of the fire will help everyone to get relief from the cold.
正像火散发出光亮，以及热量，它就使每个人驱散了他的寒冷。
But Narada Muni, he may say, well.The Lord showed his favor towards Prahlad.
Narada Muni 可能会说，主向 Prahlad 展示了他的仁慈。
But Prahlad says he considers the Lord's mercy on him to be like a dream.
但是 Prahlad 的观点就说，主对他的仁慈呢，就好像是在做梦。
So it is, in other words, he said it's just is not real.
换言之，这并不是真实的。
And the Mayavadis, they say that the Supreme Lord's mercy is all illusion.
假象宗说，至尊主的仁慈是幻象。
But Prahlad, he says that the Lord's mercy on him was unreal.In the sense of being short-lived. It was just like a dream. It didn't last very long.
但是在这里，普拉德说主的仁慈对他，主对他的仁慈不是真实的，意思是说主对他的仁慈只是很短暂的，并不持续很长。
So we may say to Prahlad, well, why should you consider that kind of affection? You know, the affection the Lord Narsingadev showed you is very famous throughout the world, and many demigods, sages, and great personalities, they all witnessed it, and they all described about it.
我们可能会反问说，那，主对普拉德的仁慈呢，在全世界都是闻名遐迩的。许多的半神人、圣哲和其他的著名的人士都亲眼目睹了呀。
And we know that Prahlad's spiritual understanding, his spiritual realization was already fully awakened when he was just a boy.
主的灵性，普拉德当他还在孩提时代的时候，他的灵性的理解力呢就已经被充分唤醒了。
And his wonderful, the wonderful qualities of Prahlad, they're also symptoms of the special favor, the mercy of the Lord on him.
Prahlad 的种种的崇高的品质都无疑展现出主对他的仁慈。
So there's no reason to hide all these facts.
所以没有理由来掩饰这些真相。
So Prahlad may say, okay, yes, the Lord's show of affection was real, but it was not evidence of the Lord's mercy.
Prahlad 呢，也许他就是说，那好吧，主的仁慈是真正的，但这并，主的慈爱是真实的，但这并不能证明主就对他真的有仁慈。
The Lord actually gives His mercy, when He grants the right to give to do service. When He gives the right to render various kinds of service, that is actually the mercy of the Lord.
当主允许一个人去从事各式各样的服务的时候，这才是他真正仁慈的体现。
And he gives that blessing to devotees like Hanuman, and nothing else is actually really his mercy.
他把这份仁慈就给了哈努曼，除此之外呢，不能说是其他的是仁慈了。
So just a little display of affection, that's not actually proof of the mercy of the Lord.
仅仅呢，展示出一点。怜爱，这并不能证明主展示了他的仁慈。
But when a devotee becomes mature and understands his eternal relationship with the Lord, then the Lord gives opportunity to serve him.
但是当一个奉献者变得成熟之后，也觉悟到他和至尊主的永恒的关系，主便给予他服务他的机会。
So devotees like Hanuman and Hanuman, how Hanuman served Lord Ramachandra. Not only Hanuman, but also his monkey friend Sugriva. They were both great devotees of, and they did a lot of service for Lord Ramachandra.
像 Hanuman 这样的奉献者，以及像 Sugriva 这样的奉献者，他们被得到了主 Ramachandra 的仁慈。
And the Pandavas, they did a lot of service for Lord Krishna.
而 Pandava 们也得到了很多服务的机会。
So Prahlad, he's trying to deny what Narada Muni is saying.
Prahlad 试图否认 Narada Muni 的话。
Narada Muni is trying to glorify him that he got the greatest mercy from the Lord, but Prahlad is saying, no, no, not me.
Narada Muni 试图赞美说 Prahlad 得到了很多的主的仁慈，但是 Prahlad 矢口否认说不，不是我。
And Prahlad also denies the importance because Narada Muni was saying that Lord Narsingadev took Prahlad And he put him on his lap and he embraced him, just like a mother embraces her child. Lord Narsingadev embraced Prahlad Maharaj, and this is a sign of the great mercy of the Lord. But Prahlad says no.
那儿的牧民呢说，主女神和队伍把普拉德抱在他的怀中，就像母亲拥抱孩子那样拥抱他，这就表明了主女神和队伍对普拉德的仁慈。但是普拉德说不，这并不是仁慈。
And Prahlad says, Lord Narsingadev performed his pastimes not just to favor me, but to protect the demigods and his devotees and to deliver two of his eternal servants.
Prahlad said, 你身的队伍上演了这些逍遥时光，并不是为了向我展示仁慈。 他的目的是为了保护半神人们，他的奉献者们，并且拯救那他的两个永恒的仆人。
Yeah, the two eternal servants, that's Jai and Vijay, who had been cursed to come.
他的两位永恒仆人是 Jai 和 Vijay, 他们遭到诅咒来到物质世界。
Lord Narsingadev also wants to uphold the truth of the words of Brahma, because Brahma had given benedictions to Hiranyakashipu. So when Lord Narsingadev appears, he has to keep intact all the benedictions which Brahma had given Hiranyakashipu.
Brahma的话 因为Brahma曾经祝福了这个Hiranyakashipu，给了他祝福，所以Nishinadev他也要来支持Brahma的这些话语。And
Lord Narsingadev also wants to show the greatness of devotional service.
主Nishinadev也为了彰显奉爱服务的伟大。
So this was the some of the reasons, the real reasons for Lord Narsingadev pastimes. Lord Narsingadev comes in that very special form to save Prahlad from Hiranyakashipu. So we may say, well, isn't that evidence to show that the Lord favors Prahlad? But Prahlad says, no, he said, the Supreme Lord appears as Lord Narsingadev to kill Hiranyakashipu and to serve other purposes, not just to please, not just to protect Prahlad Maharaj.
但是普拉德说，主女神的队伍显现，他是为了来处置Hiranyakashipu，并且还有其他的原因，而不仅仅是为了拯救普拉德。
Right. So the Lord also comes to protect the demigods like Indra, because they are his faithful devotees.
主他上演这个逍遥时光也为了保护英准，因为英准也是他的奉献者。Then
he comes also as Lord Narsingadev to get the giant Vijay free from the curse of the four Kumaras.
把斋和维斋从库马尔斯兄弟的诅咒当中拯救出来。So
the Lord Narsingadev has to keep the words of all of his different devotees.
主必须要让他的各式各样的奉献者的话语诺言兑现。Brahma
had predicted how the Lord would come as Lord Narsingadev.
Brahma 已经曾经预言了主将会以Narsingadev的形式显现。
And the four Kumaras, who are the sons of Brahma, They also predicted that Lord Nrisimhadeva would come and kill Hiranyakashipu.
Brahma 的四个儿子库玛尔四兄弟也曾经预言了主会杀死 Hiranyakashipu.
And even the Lord, Hiranyakashipu, he was actually the gatekeeper Jai. There was two gatekeepers. There was Jai and Vijai. So Hiranyakashipu, he was actually the gatekeeper Jai, and he had also made the statement that the Lord had to make true.
Hiranyakashipu 本人是主 Narayan 的一个看门人，名字叫 Jaya。他也曾经说过，主必须要说话，算话。
And then all the different predictions made by Narada and Prahlad, they had to be realized. They had to come true.
Narada 以及 Prahlad 的预言呢，也必须要实现。
So we get information about all the different predictions which were made. For example, it describes that when Hiranyakashipu asked Prahlad about whether Lord Vishnu was also present in a pillar of the palace, Prahlad said, yes, he's present everywhere.
当你 Hiranyakashipu 质问 Prahlad 主 Vishnu 在不在宫殿的柱子当中的时候， Prahlad 坚定地说，当然，他无处不在。
So because Prahlad said that, Lord Nrisimhadeva appeared from the pillar.
因为 Prahlad 是这样坚定地说了，所以主尼舍德便从柱子当中显现了。
And Prahlad had also said that the Lord is present in varieties of material creation and in the material elements.
Prahlad 之前也曾经说过，主他也在物质创造、物质的不同创造当中，并且在物质元素中。
So Lord Nrisimhadeva appeared from the pillar to kill Hiranyakashipu and to keep the words of his devotees.
因此，主尼舍德便从柱子当中蹦出来，来兑现之前的不同奉献者的话。
Just like the four Kumaras, they had said that Jai and Vijay, the two gatekeepers, that they would come back to Vaikuntha after taking three births in the material world.
Kumar 四兄弟之前说过，当 Jai 和 Vijaya 他们在物质世界投生三次之后，将重返在 Vaikuntha 的地位。
So Lord Nrisimhadeva's form was not human and not animal. It was a form like nobody had ever seen before.
主尼舍和 Dave 的形象既不是人类，也不是动物，这个形象在 Brahma 的创造当中从没见过。
And Lord Nrisimhadeva appeared at the doorway of Hiranyakashipu.
主尼舍和 Dave 是显现在 Hiranyakashipu 的宫殿的门廊。
So in this way, he kept all the benedictions which Lord Brahma had given Hiranyakashipu.
这样呢，他就让主Brahma 给 Hiranyakashipu 的所有的祝福呢，都完整无缺的体现了。
Right. Hiranyakashipu wanted that he should not meet death either inside or outside the house, so he was killed in the doorway.
Hiranyakashipu 要求呢，他不死在屋里，也不死在屋外，因此呢，他是死在这个门厅门口。
And he should not be killed by any man or any animal, so he was killed by somebody who was a half man, half animal.
铁娘他师父要求他不为任何人不为任何动物所杀，因此呢他杀死他的呢既不是人类也不是动物。
So Hiranyakashipu had said that Prahlad Maharaj had great strength because nobody was able to punish him.
Hiranyakashipu 承认呢，这个孩子他拥有巨大的力量，因为他没有任何人能够惩罚得了他。
Hiranyakashipu said, "My son appears to be immortal."
Hiranyakashipu 承认说，我的儿子好像是不朽的。
So Hiranyakashipu said that because I'm his enemy, I've been trying to kill him. Said I will die. I will be killed myself. I will have to die.
Hiranyakashipu 也承认说，由于我对于我的儿子的敌意呢，我将为此而死去。
So this was Hiranyakashipu's worry.
这就是 Hiranyakashipu 的担忧。
And Indra had wanted to kill. Indra had wanted to kill the unborn Prahlad when he was still in the womb of his mother, but Narada wouldn't allow Indra to kill him.
天帝 Indra 之前呢，本想在Prahlad 还在他母亲的子宫的时候就杀害他，但是被 Narada Muni 阻止了。
At that time, Indra told. Narada Muni told Indra that this child who is within the womb of the wife of Hiranyakashipu, that he is a faultless and he's without any sin. He's a great devotee.
Narada Muni 告诉天帝 Indra, 在这个女人子宫当中的婴儿，他是无罪的，他也是没有错误的，他是伟大的奉献者。
And he's a powerful servant of the Lord also, so you won't be able to kill him.
他还是至尊主的伟大奉献者，你杀不了他。
So all of these different words had to be kept by the Supreme Lord when Lord Nrisimhadev came.
所有之前说过的所有的这些话都必须被主所实现。
So, the Lord had to keep his own words from the Bhagavad Gita because in the Bhagavad Gita he said,My devotee will never perish. Kunti arpriti janihi nami bhakta pranashati.
之前主他还必须要兑现自己的诺言，因为他在《薄伽梵歌》中说过，昆体之子啊，勇敢地宣布我的奉献者永不毁灭。
The Lord says, Lord Krishna says, I will deliver my devotee from the ocean of birth and death.
主 Krishna 说，我会将我的奉献者迅速地拯救出生死之洋。
So Lord Nrisimhadev, what Lord Nrisimhadev did during his very brief appearance, it doesn't prove that Prahlad is the Lord's favorite devotee.
普拉德便得出结论说，主女身上内部在他短暂的显现的期间所做的行为，并不能证明普拉德是主最宠爱的奉献者。
Even though Lord Nrisimhadev made a show of neglecting Brahma and neglected the other demigods, and he showed more affection for Prahlad, but that doesn't mean that he's the greatest devotee.
即便主表面上并没有向Brahma 和其他半神人展现出他的关注，而只是表现出钟爱普拉的一个人，但并不能说明什么。
It just shows that the Supreme Lord has no affection.Either for his Vaikuntha associates like Garuda, or for the goddess of fortune, whom he also neglected.
这个显示出主 他既不钟爱既不钟爱他的外昆塔的同游格鲁的，也不钟爱他的幸运女神。在那个场合下，主都忽视了他们。
Lord Nrsingadev just wanted to bring attention to the position of pure devotional service.
主他只希望人们把注意力都聚焦在纯粹的奉爱服务上面。
He wanted to show that even a devotee, a little child like Prahlad, can get the Lord's reciprocation by remembering the Lord.
主希望通过这个事件展示出，即便是像普拉的这样一个小孩子，也可以通过恒常的冥想主得到主的仁慈。
So this is Prahlad's answer to Narada's statement. That because Narada had said that Lord Nrsingadev showed special affection for Prahlad. But Prahlad said, no, he was encouraging all the devotees to meditate and to remember his the glory of the Lord, to remember the importance of pure devotional service.
But Narada 呢，他本来是想要，就是证明，Prahlad 他得到了主尼生对付特殊的仁慈，但是 Prahlad 这一番回答呢，就回答说，主之所以这样做，只是为了彰显纯粹的奉爱服务，并且来鼓励人们意念他。
So of course, the Lord showed affection for Prahlad, but he ignored Lord Shiva and Lord Brahma and even the goddess of fortune and all the demigods. They were all offering prayers, but Lord Nrsingadev was more attracted by the prayers of Prahlad.
尽管呢，主就忽视了在场的 Brahma、Shiva 和其他供奉祷文的那些半神，甚至忽视了幸运女神。他只是在那里在鼓励着小 Prahlad。
So Prahlad Maharaj says to Narada Muni, he said, when the personality of Godhead gave me a kingdom, I understood that I had not received even one atom of his mercy.
Prahlad Maharaj 又继续说，当人格神手他赐予我一个王国的时候，我明白到我甚至连他的仁慈的一粒原子那么大的仁慈都没有得到。
Yeah, when a devotee gives up all material ambitions, then that is a sign that he's a self-realized soul.
当一旦奉献者放弃了所有物质的野心的时候，这就表明他是一个伟大的觉悟自我的灵魂。
But the greatest devotees, the greatest, the most advanced personalities are those who have also given up even the desire for liberation and also the sense, they've also given up the sense of being satisfied in impersonal realization.
连解脱的欲望也放弃了，并且放弃了在非人格的觉悟方面已经有一种满足感的时候，这样的奉献者则更加精进。
And Prahlad wants to bring out the point that people who are involved in some political responsibilities.Then they're in a fallen condition.
Prahlad 想指出，谁要是卷入了任何政治的事务、政治的 证悟的时候，他就是处在一个堕落的状态下。
So Prahlad said, Lord Nrsingadev hardly blessed me with any favor. He gave me my father's kingdom, but he actually punished me in this way. This was like a punishment by putting me in charge of my father's kingdom, because I had to be involved in all the politics.
Prahlad 声明说，当主你是那队伍把我父亲的王国交给我照管的时候，我明白到他实际上根本就没有赐福我，他实际上已经严重的惩罚了我，因为我不得不卷入到这些政治事务。
Prahlad Maharaj tells Narada Muni, he said, the Lord himself says, when I favor someone, then I make him lose all of his opulence.
普拉德说，因为主本人曾经说过，当我要是给向某人展示恩赐的时候，我就会使他失去所有的富裕。
So this is evidence, and this is also the words of the great devotees. They all confirm this.
这就是证据，因为所有伟大的奉献者都证实了。
So look, in the Srimad Bhagavatam, Lord Krishna had told Indra the same point in a different pastime, different situation, but the same point was made by Lord Krishna, that when I'm very merciful to someone, I make him lose all of his wealth.
在另外一个时空的小时光当中，圣主 Krishna 也曾经做同样的声明，当我真正的对某人展示恩赐的时候，我便逐渐的使他失去所有的财富。
And the same point is made also by Sudama, the Brahmana. And Sudama says to a devotee who doesn't have any spiritual insight, the Lord will not give the wonderful opulence of this world.
像苏达玛婆布拉玛那也布拉玛那苏达玛也曾经做过同样的声明，他说对于那些是没有欠缺灵性洞察力的奉献者，至尊主不会赐予他这个物质这个世界的奇妙的富裕。
The Lord is very wise, and He knows how people become intoxicated by pride, and that pride causes people to fall down. So this is what happens when people get some wealth.
这就是那些就得到富裕的人们发生的，他们身上发生的事情。
So Krishna is merciful when he takes all their wealth away.
当 Krishna 真正把他们财富拿走的时候，就是表明他的仁慈。
And there's another point also made when the Lord is speaking to the demon Vritasura. He tells the demon Vritasura that for people who fully surrender.At the lotus feet of the Lord, and always think of His lotus feet, then they're accepted and recognized by the Lord as His own personal servants.
至尊主还对维彻恶魔维彻苏勒摩说，那些全然臣服了至尊性格神手莲花族的人们，并且总是想着他的莲花族，这样的人。得到主的接纳，并且认可是他的个人的助手和仆人。
The Lord never gives His mercy to such. The Lord never gives the opulence of the material world to His servant.
主不会把物质富
When somebody possesses material opulence, either in the lower or the middle or the upper region of the universe, then his possessions will increase all kinds of things like pride and anxiety and disturbance of the mind. It will all come about due to opulence.
当时某人他要是拥有了在上中下物质世界上中下三个世界当中拥有了物质财富的话就会增加他的骄傲焦虑以及他的心他使他心烦意乱
And people have to go through a lot of endeavor. When that happens, people have to go through a lot of endeavor to maintain their possessions and to keep their possessions. And in this way, he suffers a lot of unhappiness when he loses them.
这样的人呢，他必须要费尽周折的维系他的和增加他的财产，而且一旦他失去这些财产的时候，他就会备受煎熬。
So Prahlad Maharaj says, you can see how my worship of the Lord has been covered by my attachment to ruling my kingdom.
普拉德说，你可以看到我对主的崇拜，由于因为要统治这个王国而依恋这种统治权，已经受到了巨大的削弱。
Also, my attachment to my family members and my servants and other things, it all covers my real service to the Lord.
我与我的家庭成员、仆人和其他的人们的关系，也都覆盖了我的奉献服务。
So I should be criticized for this. You shouldn't glorify me, you should criticize me for this.
所以你不应当荣耀我，你应当为此而谴责我。
Narada Muni, he may say that material facilities are dangerous for the immature devotees. But those who are fully very advanced devotees, they don't have to be afraid of becoming materially opulent.
那拿耳朵穆尼呢，他也许会这样说：这些物质的设施对于那些不成熟的奉献者是危险的，而对那些已经全然的自我觉悟的人们，他们无需害怕这些物质富裕。
So the Sudama Brahmana, he talked about neophyte devotees. And he talked about them, he said, those are the people who don't have any spiritual insight. And they're people who the personality of Godhead has to protect from the dangers of too much material opulence.
Sudama Brahman 曾经提到过这些新的出席的奉献者，说他们是缺乏灵性的洞察力。 而且至尊人和神手呢，必须格外的保护这些出席者，免于拥有过多的物质富裕。But
Prahlad Maharaj, he's a fully self-realized devotee, and he has mature insight. He knows the real value of the Lord's devotional service.
然而，Prahlad却是一个已经全然的自我觉悟的奉献者，他对于至尊主的奉献服务的真正价值有着成熟的洞察力。So
we may think that political power and sense gratification, that's not going to bother Prahlad Maharaj.
因此，我们便会认为。 感官享乐以及政治政权不会打扰Prahlad Maharaj。
Lord Krishna had also told Muchikunda Muchikunda, he was a great soldier who had been, you know, he was in the cave and he was sleeping. And then he opened his eyes and he burned that demon who was chasing Krishna, Kala Yavna, he burned him to ashes. So Lord Krishna told this devotee, Muchikunda, something very important.
还有一个消失光是涉及到主穆奇昆达国王的他正在一个山洞当中熟睡后来就是主就凭借就使得他杀了那卡拉亚万的魔
So Lord Krishna told Muchikunda that the intelligence of my pure devotees is never diverted, never moved from by it's never moved by any material blessings.
主就对这国王说道：“我纯洁无瑕的奉献者的智性，从来不会被物质的祝福所干扰。”
And he also told Uddhava that if somebody has unflinching devotion, then he will never be defeated by sense gratification.
主 Krishna 也曾经对乌德瓦说：“谁要是 对我怀着毫不动摇的奉爱，他永远不会被感官享乐所打败。
So Prahlad says that he says he has been distracted and deviated from pure devotion.
Prahlad 在这里呢，自称他已经从纯粹的奉爱，这条。 从纯粹的奉爱当中呢，已经分心了，并且偏离了纯粹的奉爱。
So that would mean that Prahlad never actually received the full mercy of the Lord.
他也就是，意思就是说，他自己从来没有得到至尊主的全部的仁慈。
And according to Prahlad, when Prahlad meditates on being protected by the Lord, that has become completely covered by Prahlad was he feels bad that his meditation on the Lord has become covered.
Prahlad 感觉很糟糕，因为他觉得他对主的奉爱已经被彻底的覆盖了。He
says that his devotion has become covered, not destroyed, but covered.
他说他的奉爱被覆盖了，而不是被摧毁了。And
Prahlad knows that bhakti, that devotion to the Lord is purely spiritual. And it is eternal, can never be destroyed. But it's become temporarily covered by material contamination. And Prahlad gives an example. He said, just like he said, why else would I have fought against the Lord? I fought against him when we were at Vishala. I fought as if I had gone back to the low condition of my birth. Okay, so we will stop here.
Oh, 好，那我们讲课部分到这里，接下来回答问题。
Other questions?
Yes.
上周三那个快乐源泉那个有一个问题。 他说：“顶拜咕噜队，一切荣耀归于帕布帕德和咕噜队。请问那个国王，他 他冒犯的不是一般的普通婆罗门吧？婆罗门也分层次高低吧？如果国王是主奎什那的奉献者，那他会不会就被主奎什那拿走所变其意的业报呢？
这个问题从什么地方？
就是 the listener from the
快乐源泉。
The Krishna, the source of happiness. The questions about that king, he has given the cow to a Brahmana, and then the cow went to another Brahmana. So the question is that this king has offended not an ordinary Brahmana, right?Because Brahmana, there are higher class Brahmana and low, there are different level of Brahmana. So this is the first part of the question.
Yes.
About the...
Yes, there are special Brahmanas. These Brahmanas were first class Brahmanas.
是的，这些都是一流的婆罗门。
They were learned in the scriptures.
他们都精通经典。
And they didn't have much wealth.
他们没有很多的财富。
And they had vowed also to take charity only one time.
他们也曾经都发誓，就是只接受一次布施。
So.
The next part of question that if this king is the devotee of Lord Krishna, then won't Lord Krishna take away his karma of become a lizard? If he is a devotee, then Lord Krishna will take away his karma. Then he will not become a lizard, right?
Well, he was not.So much devoted. That's the point. He was more interested to do pious activities. He was a devotee of doing pious activities. He was not devotee of Krishna so much. He was just interested to do pious activities to enjoy the results of pious activity. He
was not so much devoted to Krishna. He was not devoted to Krishna. He was very interested in doing pious activities.他想要从事前生活动呢，并且享受前生活动的果报。
嗯。Yeah.
喂，第二个问题吗？是 Sruti Rupa， 顶拜咕噜队和老师，请问咕噜，我们现在遇到困难，都会向主尼星哈祈祷，但是。又说这个形象只为拯救帕拉达大军只存在几个小时，应该怎样理解这个形象的永恒性呢？这是第一个问题，还有第二个问题。
Shruti Rupa Devadasa said, obeisance to Gurudev and teachers. Now, whenever there are difficulties, we will pray to Lord Nishindev. But in class, it is said that the form of Lord Nishinadev only exists for several hours to save Prahlad Maharaj. How to understand this form is eternal?
Well, eternal in the sense it's eternal in the spiritual world. It's not eternally present in the material world.
它的永恒性呢是存在于灵性世界，它在物质世界不是永恒。
第二个问题，请问咕噜，临终时想起奎师那的圣名，或者他的任何一个形象，或者薄伽梵歌的任何一个诗节，效果都是一样的吗？都能得到成功回归家园的保证吗？感恩咕噜队和翻译。
The second part is that Guru, when at the final moment, What about the effect of remember Lord Krishna or any of Lord Krishna's form or remember any verses of Bhagavad Gita? Is it the, is the effect all the same?
I don't understand the point. What do you mean? Is the effect always the same?
Is that guarantee that we can go back successfully back home, back to Godhead, if we remember Lord Krishna or any of the form of Krishna, or even remember any verse from Bhagavad Gita? Cannot guarantee that we can successfully go back to home.
Well, I don't know that any verse in the Bhagavad Gita will guarantee that. But if you can, it's not just remember the Lord. The important thing is to serve the Lord.
想起任何一个时节，这就说不准了。而且呢，关键点呢，不是在于想着主，而在于要服务主。
Some people may remember the Lord, they may remember him in a bad way. They don't think of him with love, they think of him with anger and hate.
有些人他也是念念不忘，但是他是满怀恨意的，或者是非常就是坏的想着主。
There are people who remember the Lord, but they don't remember him as a devotee. They remember him as a demon.
有些人呢，他不是作为奉献者想的主，他是作为恶魔在想着主。So
we have to think of him in a favorable way, remember him favorably.
因此呢，我们一定要顺意的想着主。And
more important is not just remembering, but serving.
而且更为重要的是，不仅仅是要想着主，还要服务主。
It's like Prahlad Maharaj is saying that, because Narada Muni was saying to Prahlad, you're the best devotee. Well, Prahlad said, no. He said, when I'm in trouble, I remember the Lord. But he said, there are much better devotees than me. People like Hanuman, they're always serving the Lord. They do service for him.
就像在课中提到的, Prahlad Maharaj, 他被Narada Muni 赞美, 然后Prahlad就说, 我只是在心烦意乱的时候，我想起了主。但是哈努曼他比我更，他是更伟大的奉献者，因为他总是恒常的服务。Yeah,
right. Okay.
下一个是Yogita, Yovati Sachi Devadasi. Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances of Lord Srila Prabhupada. Thank you for the wonderful class. What is the first feeling we need to cultivate in order to understand the mood of the gopis? Yuvati Sachi Bun, Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, 请接受卑微顶拜荣耀归于帕巴德，感谢您精彩的讲课。 为了理解Gopi的心绪，我们首先需要培养什么样的情感？
Well, you have to, the mood of the Gopis is to serve Krishna in separation.
Gopi们的心态呢，是在分离当中的服务心态。
Yeah, the mood of the Gopis is to do service for Krishna, to be engaged in service, and at the same time remembering Krishna and feeling separation from him and thinking, when will Krishna come?
Gopi们、牧牛姑娘们，她们一边想着主Krishna，她们一边做着服务，她们一边想着主Krishna，她们感受到与Krishna的强烈的分离之情，她们在想着主Krishna什么时候、何时才能回来。
Yes.
下一个柴塔尼亚查让哈利奎什纳顶拜咕噜，感谢翻译。这个不是问题。第二个是帕拉达说搞政治对灵修有什么好处？有好处没有什么好处，为什么？
Palad Mara says that involving in political affair is not good for spiritual practice. Why?
Well, because politics is, political affairs is, it appears to be mundane, that you have to be thinking about money and you have to think about property and you have to think about different disputes, you know, people, somebody's complaining about someone else, you have to listen to the problems, the conflicts which are going on, somebody else has got a family, you know, maybe he's got 6-7 kids, so it's not easy to send the whole family to the spiritual world, it's not easy, but if you're involved in all these material things, you know, it's a lot of anxiety. You have to think about money and you have to deal with all different issues and conflicts which are there.
Because 一个从事于政务的人呢，他满脑子里都是金钱呐，财产呐，还有人们的问题啊，还有人与人之间的争端呢、或者是如果他有六个孩子的话，他要把六个孩子都带到灵世界，并不是轻而易举的。就是这些政务呢，他显得是一个世俗的事物。
So politics, politicians, they always have to think about economic development, how to make more money, how to satisfy the senses of the people.
政治家们呢，他们就要想着考虑经济发展，怎么赚钱，怎么能满足人们的感官。
And so if you have to think about these things all day, then it's a disturbance to your devotional service.
如果一天到晚的都想着毛脑子想这些，那就肯定会打扰你的灵修。
Yeah, okay. So to be a manager or to be a politician, then it's a great disturbance to your devotion to get time to hear and chant. It's not easy.
所以，身为一个管理者或者政治家，就会打扰到他的奉爱，他就没有时间去聆听唱诵。
下一个是柴塔尼亚查当。第一个问题，有一种说法，帕拉达在主尼辛哈从柱子里出来之前，就已经看到主尼辛哈显现在柱子里，所以才那么肯定对黑莱亚卡西普说，是的，主无处不在，是这样的吗？我无法看到主，怎么像帕拉达那样对主充满信心呢？
Someone says that before, Palad Maharaj has already seen Lord Nishinadev exist in the pillar of the palace, therefore, He told Hinakashipu that, yes, the Lord is all prevailing, exists everywhere. Is it true? And I cannot see Lord myself. How can I have full confidence for Lord like Prahlad?
Well, you have to become a pure devotee like Prahlad. Then you'll see.
那你必须，您必须得是像普拉德那样成为纯粹的奉献者，那么你就能看见了。
You have to hear and chant more. You have to purify the heart. Then you will understand Krishna's everywhere and in everything.
那您必须得通过聆听、念诵、净化心灵，然后你就能明白主 Krishna 无处不在，他在万事万物之中。
Yes.
下一个是 A 的问题。哈利奎什纳说，奎什纳说，对他有坚定信心的人，感官强者永远不能击败他。怎么知道自己有坚定的信心呢？
Lord Krishna says in the class, it said, Lord Krishna said, whoever has unflinching faith to him, for that person, sense gratification will never defeat him. How can one know that he has those unflinching faith?
How can one know that one has unflinching faith? Well, you have to, if you feel that the Lord is with you and He'll never leave you, that's a sign that you have unflinching faith.
如果您感觉主时刻和您在一起，永远不会离开您，那就您就知道自己有坚定的信心了。
If you have full surrender to Krishna, that is sign that you have full faith.
如果您完全的臣服了主，这也表明您对主有全然的信心。
And whatever happens, you'll continue with devotional service.That is a sign of very strong faith.
无论生活当中发生什么样的起伏，您都不影响您的奉爱服务，这也是您有强大信心的标志。
If Krishna takes away everything from you, but you continue with devotional service, that's a sign that you have strong faith.
如果 Krishna 把您的一切都拿走，那您还在从事奉爱服务，这就表明您对您有强大的信心。
Yeah. Okay.
这个下一个下一个是 Radha Priya Dasi， 顶拜咕噜队的莲花族，感恩翻译和主持的甜美服务，帕拉的马哈扎加。是那么伟大的奉献者啊，他毫无疑问地得到尼主尼星哈的仁慈，他不认为自己得到仁慈，是否仁慈需要奉爱的资格？他是谦卑的缘故呢？
Pralhad Maharaj is so great a devotee, undoubtedly.He has got mercy from Lord Nishnadev, but he didn't regard himself, regard that he has got mercy. Is this the sign of humbleness? And is that if one want to get mercy, he has to got a qualification of devotion, he can get mercy.
Yes, you're right.It's a sign of humility. And the more you have the desire to get mercy, the more you'll get the mercy. You have to desire the mercy.
您说的很对，他这是谦卑的缘故。倘若一个人他想要得到仁慈，就会得到仁慈。
The more advanced one becomes, the more one becomes humble and thinks he's fallen.
一个人越进步，他就越谦卑，他就越认为自己是堕落的。
And the more he wants the mercy,
他就觉得自己更需要得到仁慈。
Okay.
Chaitanya Charang 第二个问题，只有被奎什纳杀死的人才能获得解脱，被奎什纳化身杀死的人。还不是不能得到解脱，这是是这样的吗
？Is it true that only those who are killed by Lord Krishna can get liberation, and those who are killed by the incarnation of Lord Krishna cannot get in liberation? Is it true?
Not completely true.
不完全对。
Lord Shiva can also give liberation.
主 Shiva 也可以给予赐予解脱。
The Lord's incarnations, they can also liberate. The question is, how do you understand liberation? What do you mean by liberation? Liberation can have different meanings. Liberated from birth and death, you mean enter in, right into the spiritual world, or you just mean liberated from the material energy? Now, liberated from the material energy gives you an opportunity to then take up better devotional service and to improve the quality of your devotional service.
就是你该怎么，问题是怎么理解解脱这件事儿？解脱可以是指的摆脱了生死轮回，进入到灵性的世界，它也可以是指摆脱了物质能量的掣肘，就人能够有机会从事更好的奉献服务，增加奉献服务的品质。
So liberation can mean, it can just mean free from material miseries, but you're still, you can still, doesn't mean you go back to Godhead. I mean, you come out of the modes of nature, liberated from the modes of nature, but you're still in this world.
还有一种理解就是摆脱了物质的痛苦。它不一定就是非得指的回归神手才是解脱，也可以指的是摆脱了物质自然属性的控制，它仍然还在，身体还在这个世界当中。
OK。
好，下一个问题是释达，神定三摩地分阶段吗？为什么是绝对层面？可以举个例子说明绝对和二元性的区别吗？
This devotee asks, are there different stages for one who has attained samadhi?
Well, samadhi means fixed mind.So somebody may be in samadhi, they may be in samadhi, their mind is fixed. But what have they fixed their mind on? So somebody may fix their mind, they may actually fix their mind on Lord Krishna, and someone else may fix their mind on just the super soul. So there are different kinds of samadhi, yeah.
确实 ,samadhi 就神定它有不同，确实不同。samadhi 它的字面意思是专注心意，但它专注于什么的，它的对象会不一样，有的是专注于 Krishna, 有的专注于超灵。
But the principle of samadhi is there, that the mind is controlled, the mind is fixed, so that's common.See, one may be a yogi, maybe a mystic yogi, and one may be a devotee.So the devotee, he's also in samadhi because he's meditating on the Lord's pastimes, he's meditating on the Lord's holy name, or he's meditating on the mission of the Lord to spread Krishna consciousness. That's also samadhi. But that's different samadhi from what the yogi who's sitting doing Astanga yoga. You see, one who's doing bhakti yoga, he can also achieve samadhi.But his samadhi is a different kind of samadhi from the samadhi of a bhakti, of the samadhi of an astanga yogi.
Samadhi 神定的原则都是共同的，都是要控制心意，专注心意，注意力专注一点。但是对于学密瑜伽师，那些修习八部瑜伽的人们，他们和奉献者的萨玛迪是不一样的。奉献者的萨玛迪，他是专注于主的消时光，专注于主的圣名，专注于传播的使命。 The next part is how to understand the absolute platform. What is the absolute platform? Can you give example to explain what's the difference between the duality and absolute platform?
Well, the absolute platform means no. The absolute platform is where the mind is fixed on the supreme absolute truth. Absolute, I mean, as you say, there's the platform of duality, and platform of duality where thinking, heat and cold, happiness and distress, friend, enemy, success and failure. But on the absolute platform, one is simply connected to Krishna in devotional service. Krishna is the form of the absolute truth. So when we come to the platform of Krishna consciousness, then we're on the absolute platform. It's a platform of constantly remembering Krishna.
Mm.
On the absolute platform, but devotee is engaged in service to Krishna, and there's no question of failure. But the results are not what we consider failure, but the success is the attempt to serve Krishna. So that is the absolute platform. We don't think of the results. We may think, oh, we got no result, or we got a very good result. That is duality. But in devotional service, we don't think about the result. We simply think service to Krishna. And service to Krishna, which is the success, and that is the absolute platform.
就是在，就是我们不考虑服务的结果，到底有没有结果，还是这个结果好不好，这都是二元的。但是我们是认为，只要是有这个努力，那就是成功的。在奉献服务当中，我们不考虑结果，我们只是认为。只是在服务 Krishna， 这就是成功的了。
An example is there. Lord Nityananda went to try to deliver Jagai and Madhai. He went with Haridas, and they went. Jagai and Madhai were drunk, and Lord Nityananda came there with Haridas, and they requested Jagai and Madhai to chant the holy name. So Jagai and Madhai became very angry, and they wanted to attack Lord Nityananda and Haridas, and they both had to run away, and so they ran away. So you may, on the material platform, you may say, oh, this was a failure, that they tried to do this, but they failed. But we don't say fail, because it's absolute platform, it's devotional service, so there's no question of failure.
和哈尔达斯塔库一起去拯救两个罪人扎嘎和马代，他们两个人都喝得醉醺醺的。然后，他主尼天丹的事实是想让他们唱个圣名，但受到了攻击。然后扎嘎马代特别生气，就攻击了尼天丹的哈尔达斯塔库。然后他们两个人，尼天丹的主尼天丹的哈尔达斯塔库就跑了。从物质的层面上看呢，好像是他们失败了，但是。 他们的努力是没有失败可言的，因为这个奉献服务是存在绝对的层面上，所以他们努力了。OK。
下一个是巴格提延宾顶拜咕噜队黑人亚卡西普作为恶魔，并不是他独立性的显现，是因为主想打斗。 而且他在不吉祥的时候出生，所以才是恶魔。那作为个体
生物的独立性在什么地方呢？如果主布拉玛不创造五种愚昧，个体生物永远不想，永远不会忘记亏什那来到物质世界，普通生物的独立性又表现在什么地方呢？
Well, the question is about the individuality or the free will. The question is that Hiranyakashipu appeared as a demon. The reason is that the Lord want to fight, have a good fight. Hiranyakashipu appeared as a demon is not due to his individuality, because Lord want to fight, and also he appeared as a demon because he was born in an inauspicious moment. So as a individuality, as a living entity, so what's the existence of his individuality?
It doesn't make sense. What's the existence of his individuality?
作为个体生物的独立性在什么地方？
Dually seen as independence.
Okay. Oh, yes. Independence. 独立性在什么地方？This is the first part of the question.That as an individual living entity, I'm not very clear about question.
Whose question is this?
Yanbin, Bakting Yanbin.
Maybe that's the problem with Bakting.
并不是他独立性的。Let me try again. Hiranyakashipu appeared as demon. It's not to his due to his independence. He appeared as demon because Lord want to fight, and he appeared at inauspicious moment. Therefore, he appeared as demon.
Yes.Okay. So then.
So, 那作为个体生物的独立性在什么地方？ So how can we,
Well, who is independent? Yeah, who has independence? You know, we're all controlled. Our independence is either to surrender to Krishna or surrender to Maya.
就我们不是独立的，我们都是受到控制的。我们或者是要臣服 Krishna， 或者是要臣服 Maya。
So Jai and Vijay, where they were doorkeepers in Vaikuntha, and the Lord desired to fight.
斋和维斋是瓦昆特的守门人，主想要的战斗。
And so the Lord arranged that Jai and Vijay they would go to the material world so they could fight him.
所以主就安排了斋和维斋要去物质世界，好和他打斗。
So why did Jai and Vijay have to go? Why were they picked to go?
那为什么就是是斋和维斋亚去了物质世界？为什么他们被选择去了物质世界
？Well, one reason was because the goddess of fortune was not happy with them.
其中一个原因是由于幸运女神啊对这两个人不满意了。
That the goddess of fortune was coming to see her husband Lord Narayan one day, but they stopped her from coming. They said, "You can't go now. Just the Lord is resting. You have to wait."
幸运女神 想来见自己的丈夫，但是受到了阻止。这两个人守门人对他说：“嗯，你不能去，因为主正在休息。”
So because he displeased the goddess of fortune, they got cursed by her, and that resulted why they had to go to the material world.
因为他们两个人没嗯，就是令幸运女神不高兴了，令她不内心不悦，遭到了诅咒。所以他们两个人来到物质世界了。
And of course, the four Kumaras, they'd also come to Vaikuntha, and Jai Vijay had stopped them from coming in.
嗯，之前就是库马，后来就库马四兄弟他们想要进入到Vaikuntha，但是也遭到了阻止。
So because they had some problems with their service, they had that curse on them from the goddess of fortune and then from the four Kumaras that resulted to them coming to material world.
因为他们的服务出现了问题，嗯，他们令幸运女神不悦，并且又令库马尔四兄弟不悦，所以他们导致他们来到物质世界了。
But we also know that the Lord wanted them to come so that he could have a fight.
嗯，我们也知道主也想让他们来，好让主可以跟他们打。
So it was all the plan of Krishna. Krishna is the supreme independent person. We are not independent. We only have very small independence.
这都是 Krishna 的计划。Krishna 是至高无上的独立的人，我们不是至高无上独立的人，我们只有很微小的独立性。
Our independence is either to surrender to Krishna or surrender to Maya.
我们的独立性就体现在我们选择是臣服 Krishna 还是选择向 Maya 臣服。
Okay, yeah.
The next part of, if Lord Brahma hasn't created five kinds of ignorance, then the living entities will never forget Krishna and come to the material world. So what's their independence in this regard?
Well, you have to understand that ignorance, the five kinds of ignorance, the creation of Brahma, the five kinds of ignorance, that this is the plan of Lord Krishna.
Brahma 创造了五种愚昧也是 Krishna 的计划。
The material world is created for all the rebellious souls.
物质世界被创造出来是给那些有反叛精神的灵魂居住的。
So the conditioned souls come into the material world, and Brahma creates the five kinds of ignorance so that they can be happy here in the material world.
嗯嗯，个体灵魂呢，他们来到物质世界，嗯 ，Brahma 他创造了这五种愚昧，好让他们在物质世界能感到些许的快乐。
But we actually.We see some people, they're actually happy here. They think they're enjoying. We have our home, we have our family, we have our children, we have our money. We're thinking, this is my home, this is very nice here.
他们那个就是在物质世界待的还挺快乐的，自得其乐，觉得哎，这是我的家，这是我的钱，这是我的家人，这地方挺好的，我在这待着挺好。
So Krishna created all, Brahma creates all this ignorance just so that we can be comfortable here in this material world because we chose to turn away from Krishna.
嗯 ，Brahma 创造的这五种愚昧呢，就使得生物体居住在这里就感觉到很舒适，因为他们选择了背离 Krishna。
So we have that independence. Either you come to Krishna or you go to Maya.
所以我们有这样的，我们的独立性是体现在我们是可以选择向 Krishna 臣服，还是选择向 Maya 臣服。
And because we come to Maya, so then we come under the five kinds of ignorance.
因为我们选择了臣服玛雅，所以我们就处在五种愚昧的控制之下。
And we have our karma. Everybody has their own karma from the past activities you've done.
我每个人呢都由于前生以前过往的karma 果报活动，所以我们有自己的 karma。
So this is actually we only have very slight independence.
事实上呢，我们独立性是特别的微小的。
Either you take shelter of the material energy, or you take shelter of the spiritual energy.
你要么就可以去脱避于物质能量，要么可以脱避于 Krishna.
Either way, both the material or the spiritual energy, we're controlled. It's arranged. We're not independent.
无论你是就是脱避 Krishna 还是脱避物质能量也好，脱避于灵性能量也罢，这我们都是受到控制的，这已经是被安排好了的，我们并不是独立的。
Okay. Yes.
下一个是下一个吗？
啊，下一个。
柴坦亚柴。查让第三个问题，帕拉达那时候上课也是男女分开的吗？听说玛雅普学院的学生学习是帕布跟马达基分开学习，而且授课老师也是帕布给帕布上课，马达基给马达基上课，这种分开授课有什么原因吗？有什么特别意义吗？
Chaitanya Charanpav is asking that what's the significance of separate men and women, they go to different school. And he asked during the period of Prahlad Maharaj.
Yeah, okay. All right. So the separation, it makes a better atmosphere for study.But if men and women are together, there's always a distraction between the men and the women. And so separate them, and the men can concentrate on their studies, and they have a male teacher, and it's a very nice atmosphere for study. But when you put women in there, then it's a different atmosphere. And it's better for the ladies also, that they're all together, and they have a lady teacher.Because a woman teacher can understand the minds of the girls better. You put a man there, he cannot understand the mind of the girls. But a woman teacher can understand the minds of the ladies. She's a woman, so she knows, she can relate to them much better.
这种分校，男女分校，并且分开老师授课，为了创造更好的学习氛围，如果他们男女混合在一起呢，容易造成分心，使得他们不能好好的专心学习。如果是女人，男子和男子在一起学习呢，他们就更加专心。但如果有女子加入了，那氛围就不一样了。同样的，如果他们女子有女老师来教他们，是因为女老师呢，她可以更加理解女子的心理，能够更加感同身受，而男子不能理解女子的心理。
So this actually, other places they also do like that. They find that when you separate the men from the men, then they can study better. They concentrate better on their work.
在别的地方，他们也是这种制度的，使得他们分开分校。并且他们会更好的学习，就是觉得这种非常有效果。
Okay.
下一个是萨提马达吉，顶拜咕噜对，等一下，顶拜咕噜马哈拉加的莲花族，顶拜所有的奉献者，请问我们应该随时感恩主通过他的代表和奉献者给予的人
给予我们的仁慈，还是应该像帕拉达马哈拉加一样，觉得自己没有任何资格，不可能得到主的仁慈呢？
Sati Manaji is asking whether or not should we feel that we have God's mercy. Should we be very thankful that the Lord has given us mercy through his representative and devotees, or should we feel that we have no qualification, we cannot get mercy from the Lord, like Prahlad Maharaj?
Yes, we should feel we've got mercy from our spiritual teacher.
我们应该觉得我们得到了灵应导师的仁慈。
And we should feel the mercy of, we should feel that mercy by the mercy of the spiritual teacher, then you get the mercy of the Lord.
并且感受到通透过灵性导师，我们得到了主的仁慈。
So, of course, we're far away from the Lord, but whatever progress we've made is by the mercy of our spiritual teacher.
当然，我们距离主还很遥远，但是无论我们取得了什么样的进步，都是由领导者的仁慈。
The devotee will always appreciate the mercy of his spiritual teacher.
所以奉献者们他们会欣赏或者感激、感恩。灵性导师的仁慈。
下一个吗？
Yeah.
这个名字我，这个名字我念
的。Dirija David Dasi.
顶拜咕噜马哈拉加的莲花族，顶拜所有的奉献者帕拉达马哈拉加，不怕恶魔之手父亲，不怕父亲108种。方法迫害他，却怕，却最害怕和普通人联谊。我们传教不都是接触普通人吗？请问咕噜，这里的普通人如何界定？为什么帕拉德害怕与普通人联谊呢？
Girija David Dasi said that Palamara was not afraid of his demonic father, and he was not afraid of his father has tried to kill him through 108 methods. Yet Palamara was afraid to associate with ordinary person. If we try to preach, we have to contact those ordinary person. So how to define, what's the definition of ordinary person? Why Prahlad Maharaj was afraid to associate with ordinary person?
Prahlad Maharaj felt compassion. I don't know about being afraid to associate with them. I don't know where is that from. I don't recall seeing this, but I know that Prahlad Maharaj felt compassion. He felt sorry for the people in material existence who've made family life the center of their existence and who are only thinking about their home and their economic situation. And they only think about these material things, and they have no time. They never think about any kind of connection to higher purpose of life. So Prahlad Maharaj thinks about these people, and he feels very sorry for them, that they're in so much ignorance and they're so attached to their material situation.
Prahlad Maharaj, he is. 就是对于这个处在物质存在状况当中的人呢，心怀怜悯，同情他们。这些人他们是以家庭生活为中心，总是想着他们的家，想着他们的经济状况。他们没有时间去考虑生命的更高的目标， 所以普拉马哈拉对这些人感到很难过，因为他们很愚昧，他们依附于他们的物质生活。
So, certainly, as devotees, we're cautious about associating with materialistic people, people who are offenders and blasphemers of the devotees. Anybody who blasphemes the Lord or the Lord's devotees, then we will avoid their association. We don't want to go near these people.
奉献者们，他们对于和物质主义者打交道是很谨慎的，这是指的那些冒犯者，还有那些亵渎者，他们亵渎奉献者，亵渎主，所以奉献者们会避免和这样的人联谊，不要接近他们。
Yeah.还有问题吗？
还有的，这个是马兔甘地林维达西，亲爱的咕噜队，顶拜您的莲花组，我每天早上念诵总是念着念着就睡着，脑子里也总是出现很多影像，其他的时间怎么念也不会困，也不会睡着。应该怎么办呢？
Well, instead of trying to sit down and just chant, maybe you should stand up and go for a walk. Sometimes you can go for a japa walk, that's also good. And sometimes you can also open the windows and let fresh air in, and then you can chant louder. All of these things will stop you from...being drowsy and sleepy when you chant.
那么就是您念诵的时候就不要坐着念了，这样您就可以站起来或者出去，就一边japa一边散步走路，或者是可以开着窗户让新鲜空气进来，或者是您大声的念诵，这样您就不会昏昏欲睡。
And she's saying some other times during the day she can chant better?
During the other times, she was not sleepy. Only in the early morning.
Well, early morning is an auspicious time for chanting, though.
但是清晨念诵是吉祥的时间。
You have to train your mind.
Yeah. 您得训练心意。
You have to be more determined.
您需要就是下定决心。
You can chant during the day. You should be able to chant early morning. My early morning is a more powerful time to chant.
您既然可以在白天念诵不睡，那您在清晨的时间也更可以了，因为在清晨的念诵是更有力量。
So I'm telling you, you maybe you open the windows and or you drink some cold water.Or do something to keep yourself more alert. You can do it. You have to be more determined.
所以就像刚才顾叔跟你说的，你也可以喝一些冷水，然后就使您保持警觉，然后您还得就是特别有决心。
嗯哼。
下一个咕噜妈咪，你来。
这是一个俄文，我 Rajani 对不对？
他的问题是 Hare Krishna， 咕噜妈哈扎姐，请接受我卑微的顶拜，所有的荣耀归于帕布帕的。按照这个，这方面是 Jai 故事。什么的故事来说，如果我们让某个奉献者不满意我们的行为服务，我们也会越服务越不好吗？谢谢。如果我们发现我们的服务质量下降这样是否
是否能够判断有谁对我们不满意吗？您的仆人乌拉加扎尼，嗯，读完了。
According to the story of Javajaya, they displease the devotees by their when they are doing the service. So if we also displease devotees by our action and service, and we will also become, our service will become worse. Is that right? Thank you. And also, if our, the quality of our service has gone down, can we judge that somebody must be displeased with us?
Well, you should always think about trying to please the devotees. Try to please Krishna and please the devotees. You should want to do that. You should want to be contemplating on that. Whatever you do it for the pleasure of devotees. If devotees are not pleased, it's not very good, certainly.
您应该努力的，总是想着努力的去取悦奉献者，取 Krishna， 想着Krishna 的快乐。如果奉献者们对我们不高兴，那无疑这不太好。
So yes, if you don't please the devotees, then certainly then our service will go down, and we may get more reactions. And we can lose our taste for Krishna consciousness. 所以 you have to be very conscious, try to please the devotees, try to think why are the devotees not pleased, and try to do something to help them, to try to serve the devotees. We know it's difficult being with devotees sometimes, it's difficult. Sometimes we describe the devotees, devotee is compared to a chutney. Prabhupada taught devotees how to make a chutney. A chutney is a jam where you get some things like some fruit and you cook them together, maybe apple chutney or tomato chutney, and you cook it, and you put spices in it. And you put sugar there. So the chutney, it should be very sweet, so sweet that you cannot resist it, but at the same time it should be very hot, so hot that you difficult to taste it or to tolerate it. But it's so sweet, you can't resist it. And so association with devotees is a bit like that. The devotee association can be very sweet, but it can be also very hot. So, we do have to be tolerant. We do have to try to put up, the good, the bad things. But at the same time, there's also good things.
那当然了，如果那个奉献者不高兴了，我们应该想着为什么奉献者不高兴了，那么可以采取什么弥补措施，来就是努力的去服务他们，使得他们，变得高兴起来。就帕帕德形容说，奉献者联谊，当然和奉献联谊不那么的容易，是挺难的。帕帕德说，跟奉献联谊啊，就像是就是吃那种果酱啊，这种果酱，比如有苹果酱或者西红柿酱。你把它们做好之后呢，然后加上糖，再加上香料。一方面呢，它特别甜，你无法拒绝它；另外一方面呢，它是特别的辛辣的，就是也是挺难的，挺难下咽的。但是同时它特别甜，你无法抗拒它。所以奉献者联谊呢，就有点像这个吃这个果酱，就是非常。辛辣，一方面又非常甜，香甜可口；一方面又非常辛辣，所以， 和枫叶联谊，有点像这样子的。
OK， 还有问题吗？
还有两个问题，咕噜队。
好。
嗯嗯嗯，巴格迪延边，嗯、顶拜咕噜队，雅都王朝是被优噶玛雅覆盖，还是被马哈玛雅覆盖呢？
The devotee of the Yadu dynasty, they're all pure devotees, they're great devotees, so it's Maya, it's Yoga Maya, it's not Maha Maya.
Yadu 王朝的奉献者，他们都是伟大的奉献者，他们是被 Yoga Maya 覆盖，不是 Maha Maya.
还有问题？
还有一个那个Sruti Rupa， 顶拜咕噜队，这段时间出去户外加帕的时候，聆听着圣明和稻田里的蛙鸣蝉叫声音，感觉就像天籁之音，从而心里非常喜悦，念诵也会很专注，请问咕噜队，这样会取悦主吗？
I didn't get all of it.
Shruti Rupa, Deva Das said that when I go out to do japa work, I heard the frogs are the song from the nature, like those from the frog, and I feel very pleased to hear those sound. Can this kind of japa please the Lord?
Well, the japa which pleases the, doing japa, you want to hear the sound of the holy name, not the sound of the frogs.
当你就是念诵圣名，去做japa的时候呢，就是您是希望听到的是圣名，而不是听到那个蝉鸣，不是蛙青蛙叫。
You have to be careful, you're chanting japa, you want to concentrate on the holy name. That you can appreciate nature, you can think, oh, nature sounds so very nice. You become attached to the croaking of frog, you bet next life you may become a frog. You have to be very careful.
就是您得念诵的时候呢，您还专注于圣名最好是，当然就是您很欣赏大自然。然后但是如果问题就是，如果您依附于这个蝉鸣，不是就是青蛙叫的话，下一辈子可能会变成青蛙。
So we have to be careful to keep the mind fixed on Krishna. Understand the sounds of nature, those nice sounds, that they're all creations of Krishna.
所以我们要小心，将心意专注于 Krishna。当我们听到这个大自然的声音的时候，我们要联想到这都是 Krishna 的创造。
Don't just think about the frogs, but think about Krishna.
所以就不要只想着青蛙，还要想到 Krishna。
Mm-hmm. OK。
好的，咕噜队，没有问题了。
好。OK， 所以我们今天讲到这里。我们感谢 Guru Mani 给我们翻译，我们感谢 Padma Mukhi Mataji 住持，感谢所有的奉献者聆听，我们祝福你，长寿快乐，万事如意 ，Hare Krishna。
Hare Krishna，
古鲁帝圣者玛拉
吉。Shri Prabhupada Ki Jai。
Jai。
Gaur Bhakti Vrinda Ki Jai。